Yo, what's good, everyone? This is AYO Boxing with Madiba, and here's my post-fight review for Terrence Crawford versus Errol Spence Jr. There's no doubt that Terrence Bud Crawford is pound-for-pound number one and an all-time great after this performance. Everyone thought this was a 50-50 fight, and I predicted Crawford to win by late-round stoppage, but I didn't think Crawford would beat Spence in the fashion that he did. I was expecting a competitive fight with several momentum shifts, however, Crawford dominated Spence. It was really a fish fry, and I was surprised. I low-key felt bad for Spence, but Terrence Crawford is on a different level. In my prediction video, I stated that Crawford's counterpunching ability would make a difference in this fight, and it did. To be a great counterpuncher, you need to analyze your opponent and have great timing. And we saw Crawford do this immediately. Because in round one, Spence was trying to establish his rhythm and dictate the pace, working behind his jab in order for him to make his way to the inside and work the body and then overwhelm Crawford. However, Crawford's jab was disrupting Spence's strategy. Crawford's jab was accurate, fast, and powerful. Spence was getting caught with the jab when he was coming in. Spence was able to work his way inside on occasions, but Crawford's jab and footwork kept the fight at the mid-range for the majority of the round, allowing Crawford to set up counterpunching opportunities. And this would dictate the rest of the fight because in round 2, Spence would increase his output and work rate, but Crawford remained composed, staying behind his jab, and was able to land several counterpunches, especially the left hand. Crawford would then knock down Spence with a left hand counter followed up by a stiff jab when Spence was off balance. But the biggest takeaway from that round is Crawford pushing Spence off of him when Spence made his way to the inside. Going into this fight, it was assumed that Spence was a stronger fighter and his physicality would be his advantage. However, that push showed that Crawford is a stronger fighter and that he could deal with Spence's inside game. And this would be the downfall for Spence because Crawford would go on to beat the hell out of Spence from round 3 onwards. Crawford had already timed Spence and became comfortable fighting Spence on the inside. Crawford's jab was busting up Spence's face, and Spence could not make an adjustment to that jab. He kept his head on the line and kept trying to go forward, trying to force his way inside, but this provided Crawford opportunities to counterpunch, catching Spence in between punches, landing heavy overhand lefts, left hooks, right uppercuts, and right hooks. Crawford was up in the pace and aggression in each round, even forcing Spence on the back foot, and Crawford was also fighting off the back foot. He was just in control in every aspect of the fight. Going forward, going backwards, everything. Spence would get dropped twice in round 7, and it looked like he was going to get stopped, but survived. At that point, Spence had no answers. Derrick James was giving instructions, but his fighter could not apply that in the ring, because Crawford was just in control. Crawford would eventually go on to stop Spence in round 9, and it was appropriate because Spence was taking too much damage. All in all, it was a great fight. Crawford has been one of my favorite fighters for a long time, but this fight sealed the deal. He is my favorite fighter of this era. A lot of people, including the fans and boxing media, had doubted and downplayed Crawford's career and accomplishments, saying that he hasn't fought nobody, that he cherry picks, saying all types of shit. But after tonight, you cannot deny him. Respect to Errol Spence, despite being outclassed, he kept on fighting and was willing to put all on the line. There's a rematch clause that Spence can activate. The rematch will take place at 154 and has to happen before the year is up. But in my opinion, there shouldn't be a rematch. Crawford has already shown that he's a superior fighter in all aspects, and Spence will get beat up again. Maybe 154 will benefit Spence since he won't have to cut so much weight, but I doubt it. But who knows, this is boxing, anything can happen. But thank you for tuning in with AYO Boxing with Madiba. Hit like and subscribe, and more content is coming your way.